Howdy guys, I am back with more Mass Effect. Last time I landed on Ilos and I left you guys here in the archives with all the stasis pods of the Protheans that, well, became their final resting place, right? This music, man, it really gets to me. I really love this. I actually listened to it while I went to bed last night, so I fell asleep listening to this music. Someone uploaded like a 2-hour version of this song looping over and over. Anyway, let's get out of here.
What is happening?
Oh.
It's a trap. Saren must have set an ambush.
I do not think Saren is behind this.
Alright, do I go through this? No. I don't. No, I don't. I don't. I can't shoot through it, so I guess... Can we walk through it? No?
Area secured.
Oh, okay. Here we go. There's a door over here on the left that I can go through, maybe. Can I touch it? Okay. Green usually means you can walk through it. Looks like there's something here. Oh, here we go. An elevator. Oh, man. So, I guess this is the... is this the final stretch of the game? I'm not sure if this is it or if there's a lot...
I have studied the Protheans for decades, but I have never felt this sense of foreboding. What will we find down there?
Whatever it is, we should be careful.
Oh, jeez. I'm so nervous the way these guys are talking. More of these stasis pods. Gosh, this place is covered in them. Vigil.
You are not Prothean, but you are not machine either. This eventuality was one of many that was anticipated. This is why we sent our warning through the beacons.
Looks like some kind of VI program. Pretty badly damaged.
I do not sense the taint of indoctrination upon any of you. Unlike the other that passed recently, perhaps there is still hope.
This is incredible. An actual Prothean VI, and I can understand it.
I have been monitoring your communication since you arrived at this facility. I have translated my output into a format you will comprehend. My name is Vigil. You are safe here for the moment, but that is likely to change. Soon, nowhere will be safe.
Wow. Yeah, you know, the music was actually called Vigil's theme, and well, now I know who Vigil is. Wow, this is so cool. What are you?
Are you some kind of artificial intelligence program?
I am an advanced non-organic analysis system with personality imprints from Kesad Aishan, chief overseer of the Ilos research facility.
What do you want? I don't want to be mean to this. Get to the point. I don't have time for this. This is amazing. I wish there was a little wheel choice for, oh my gosh, I'm in awe. Can I just stand in front of you for a few minutes? All right, so what do you want?
Why did you bring me here?
You must break a cycle that has continued for millions of years. But to stop it, you must understand, or you will make the same mistakes we did. The Citadel is the heart of your civilization and the seat of government, as it was with us, and as it has been with every civilization that came before us. But the Citadel is a trap. The station is actually an enormous mass relay. One that links to dark space, the empty void beyond the galaxy's horizon. When the Citadel relay is activated, the Reapers will pour through, and all you know will be destroyed.
Oh my gosh, really? There's millions of people that live on the Citadel that just... That's their... Oh my gosh. God, I didn't see that coming. That makes sense, though. Citadel as a relay.
How come nobody ever noticed the Citadel was an inactive mass relay?
The Reapers are careful to keep the greatest secrets of the Citadel hidden. That is why they created a species of seemingly benign organic caretakers.
The Keepers.
The Keepers maintain the station's most basic functions. They enable any species that discovers the Citadel to use it without fully understanding the technology. Reliance on the Keepers ensures no other species will ever discover the Citadel's true nature. Not until the relay is activated and the Reapers invade.
Oh my gosh! I gotta pick up my jaw off the floor here. Wow. I mean, the keeper, I went around scanning all of them. They're just little stupid looking green giant grasshoppers. Oh my gosh. And then that, what else did they say about the keepers? That if you try to capture one or something, they just die or... Oh my god. Okay, Reapers in dark space.
How do the Reapers survive out in dark space?
We have only theories. The researchers here came to believe the Reapers enter prolonged states of inactivity to conserve energy. This allows them to survive the thousands and thousands of years it takes for organic civilization to rebuild itself. But in this state, they are vulnerable. By retreating beyond the edges of the galaxy, they ensure no one will accidentally discover them. They keep their existence hidden until the Citadel relay is activated.
So why do the Reapers want to destroy everything, though, if they just... Alright, we got everyone to build civilization, we can go screw off for a few thousand years, and then they come back and destroy it again, and then they come back and destroy it again, but I just want to understand why. What's the point in allowing these civilizations to develop just to wipe them out? There has to be a purpose, right? I mean, they're just not, I'm bored, let's go destroy things. It's like, but why are they doing it? Do they... We won't stand a chance. Saren's going to activate it. The perfect trip. Saren's going to activate it.
If he turns on the relay, the Reapers can wipe out the Council and the Citadel fleet in one fell swoop.
That was our fate. Our leaders were dead before we even realized we were under attack. The Reapers seized control of the Citadel, and through it, the mass relays. Communication and transportation across our empire were crippled. Each star system was isolated, cut off from the others. Easy prey for the Reaper fleets. Over the next decades, the Reapers systematically obliterated our people. World by world, system by system, they methodically wiped us out.
Wow. That's exactly what happened, because you go to the worlds that have Prothean ruins and there's nothing left. I don't even know. I still don't even really know what the Protheans even look like. Oh my gosh. All of you. You didn't surrender. Yeah, all of you? I don't know which one of these to pick. I want to pick both of them. I mean, I'm they're machines that can't be reasoned with, obviously. But if I feel like if I pick why you pick you didn't surrender, I'll figure out what the Reapers want. But how could they have... I also want to know, how could they have got every single Prothean? All of you? You didn't surrender. I don't know which one to pick. You didn't surrender.
The war was lost. If you'd surrendered, they might have let you live.
No offer of surrender was ever given. Our enemy had a single goal. The extinction of all advanced organic life. Through the Citadel, the Reapers had access to all our records, maps, census data. Information is power, and they knew everything about us. Their fleets advanced across every settled region of the galaxy. Some worlds were utterly destroyed. Others were conquered, their populations enslaved. These indoctrinated servants became sleeper agents under Reaper control. Taken in as refugees by other Protheans, they betrayed them to the machines. Within a few centuries, the Reapers had killed or enslaved every Prothean in the galaxy. They were relentless, brutal, and absolutely thorough.
Yeah, why did the Reapers leave? Why do they do this? This is what I want to know. Why? Why do they do this?
What do the Reapers get out of this? Why do they keep repeating this pattern of genocide over and over?
The Reapers are alien, unknowable. Perhaps they need slaves or resources. More likely, they are driven by motives and goals organic beings cannot hope to comprehend. In the end, what does it matter? Your survival depends on stopping them, not in understanding them.
I disagree, because the cycle can be broken if we understand their motives and we can stop what's motivating them to do this over and over again, but... Maybe not, you know, the Prothean, or this thing, Vigil here, is sitting here saying that we can't understand them, and You know, when I think about how I talked to Reaper on Vermeier, or the Reaper on Vermeier, Sovereign, he even said that we are each like a legion or a nation or whatever, so, you know, they've got some kind of complex way of thinking that I guess I just can't understand, so I guess maybe I don't need to understand them, maybe I just need to defeat them, but I want to understand them, I really do. Gosh, man, so why did the Reapers leave?
I don't understand. Where did the Reapers go after they conquered your people?
Our worlds were stripped bare, harvested by the indoctrinated slaves. Everything of value, all resources, all technology was taken. Certain that all advanced organic life had been extinguished, the Reapers retreated back through the Citadel relay into dark space, sealing it behind them. All evidence of the Reaper invasion had been wiped away. Only their indoctrinated slaves were left behind, abandoned. Mindless husks, no longer capable of independent thought, the indoctrinated soon starved or died of exposure. The genocide of the Protheans was complete.
Wow. So how can I stop them?
You said you brought me here for a reason. Tell me what I need to do.
The conduit is the key. Before the Reapers attacked, we Protheans were on the cusp of unlocking the mysteries behind mass relay technology. Ilos was a top-secret facility. Here, researchers worked to create a small-scale version of a mass relay, one that linked directly to the Citadel, the hub of the relay network.
The conduit is not a weapon. It is a backdoor onto the Citadel.
Man, you know, and that's, I think it's kind of interesting that Vigil, I'm backing up a little bit, but that Vigil mentioned that information is power, and, you know, the Reapers had all of, you know, they had, everyone had a number, right? You know, everyone has, like, a social security, or, you know, everyone in an advanced society is documented and accounted for the most part, right? So, now, so, you know, a couple hundred years from now, they'll probably be even better at that, and so, you know, if you have, you can't live off the grid, you're gonna be wiped out, and I mean, I just think about all the little tiny places that you, on Earth, that you can just be off the grid, and no one will probably ever find you, and the Reapers found everybody and killed them, or enslaved them. Nothing was left, not even a couple out in the woods somewhere, everything, and that's just staggering for me to think about, that nothing survived at all. It seems like, you know, a couple would have held out somewhere, but no, the Reapers found and destroyed everything. No one, not even a cracked cell phone was left behind, everything. So they didn't find you?
How did you manage to stay hidden?
All official records of our project were destroyed in the initial attack on the Citadel. While the Prothean Empire came crashing down, Ilos was spared. We severed all communication with the outside, and our facility went dark. The personnel retreated underground into these archives. To conserve resources, everyone was put into cryogenic stasis. I was programmed to monitor the facility and wake the staff when the danger had passed. But the genocide of an entire species is a long, slow process. Years passed, decades, centuries. The Reapers persisted, and my energy reserves were dwindling.
Oh my gosh, so they went into stasis thinking someday they'd wake up, and they never woke up again, and I'm just here among their bodies. Oh my gosh, this is heavy, man. Alright, so you just hid. What did you do? You were cowards. I mean, I don't think that was cowardly. They were trying to preserve what was left of them. You know, there was nothing left. That was their only chance that a few could hold out and, you know, understand the Reapers, do something against them. But even that couldn't be done. So what did you do?
How did you survive?
I began to disable the life support of non-essential personnel. First support staff, then security. One by one, their pods were shut down to conserve energy.
Oh, man.
Eventually, only the stasis pods of the top scientists remained active. Even these were in danger of failing when the Reapers finally retreated back through the Citadel relay.
There were hundreds of stasis pods out there. You just shut them down? You killed them?
He had to. There was no energy. I mean, you know, power has to come from somewhere. You know, you can't just run off of sunbeams and love, you know. I mean, it has to come from something. It was, I mean, as horrible as it is, you betrayed them, that's monsters. It was necessary.
He couldn't let everyone die. Better to sacrifice some so others could live.
This outcome was not completely unforeseen. My actions were a result of contingency programming entered on my creation.
But they didn't tell the non-essential staff about this contingency.
Probably not.
I saved key personnel. When the Reapers retreated, the top researchers were still alive. My actions are the only reason any hope remains. When the researchers woke, they realized the Prothean species was doomed. There were only a dozen individuals left, far too few to sustain a viable population. Yet they vowed to find some way to stop the Reapers from returning. A way to break the cycle forever. And they knew the Keepers were the key.
The Keepers? Really? The Keepers? Those little stupid green grasshoppers, those benign little grasshoppers that I had to go scan, that I kind of low-key hate because of that stupid quest. They're the key. The Keepers were the key. I'm losing my mind over here. You know, I'm just... I can't handle this game right now. This is great. Okay, the Keepers.
Aren't they under the influence of the Reapers?
The Keepers are controlled by the Citadel. Before each invasion, a signal is sent through the station compelling the Keepers to activate the Citadel relay. After decades of feverish study, the scientists discovered a way to alter this signal. Using the conduit, they gained access to the Citadel and made the modifications. This time, when Sovereign sent the signal to the Citadel, the Keepers ignored it. The Reapers are trapped in dark space.
Wow. Okay, so that's why they're looking for the conduit, so that they can change it. Okay. So how can they come back unless Saren succeeds? Okay. So how can they come back?
Saren must have some plan to undo everything you did.
The one you call Saren will use the conduit to bypass the Citadel's defenses. Once inside, he will transfer control of the station to Sovereign. Sovereign will override the Citadel systems and manually open the relay, and the cycle of extinction will begin again.
No, man. Not this time. Just tell me what to do. Can you help me? Not this time, because Shepard's gonna shoot things.
I'll take Sovereign down. Somehow.
There's a data file in my console. Take a copy when you go. When you reach the Citadel's master control unit, upload it to the station. It will corrupt the Citadel's security protocols and give you temporary control of the station. It might give you a chance against Sovereign.
Wait. Where's the Citadel's master control unit? I've never heard of anything like that.
Through the conduit. Follow Saren. He will lead you to your destination.
Oh my gosh, I like how there's a little off-screen Garrus that Liara and Shepard keep looking at over there. Oh my gosh, I don't know if I want that kind of power. Temporary control over the... Oh my, okay, so... I don't know if this will tell me anything new, if he's just gonna repeat stuff, so I'll click on this Prothean scientists.
What happened to the survivors from the Conduit Project?
They use the conduit to gain access to the Citadel, but the conduit is only a prototype. The portal only links in one direction, so they were trapped on the station. I do not know what became of them then. It is unlikely they found any food or water on the station. I fear they suffered a slow, grim death. I only know they succeeded in their mission to seal the relay. Your presence here proves their sacrifice was not in vain.
My gosh, so thousands of years ago, what was left of the Protheans woke up from this tomb. They basically almost came back from the dead, you could almost say, and, you know, with what food was left in their tummies, they went and closed off the relay, and And then 50,000 years later, you know, it finally came around and helped us. It's like, man, I can't imagine giving up my life for something that might happen thousands and thousands and thousands of years later. Yeah, or I mean, even hundreds of years later, I just can't fathom that. And these Protheans, they did that. And then they died, slowly and painfully. Man, this is heavy. Alright. So it sounds like he kind of just tells me a little bit more details about stuff, so I'm gonna read all the, or listen to him. So let's talk about Sovereign.
If the Reapers are trapped in dark space, how did Sovereign get here?
It is logical to assume the Reapers would leave one of their own behind after each extinction. A sentinel to pave the way for their inevitable return. Like those in dark space, Sovereign probably spent most of the last 50,000 years in a state of hibernation. Periodically, it would wake to analyze the situation. Keeping its existence hidden, it would evaluate the state of galactic civilization. And when the time was right, it would signal the Citadel and usher in the next Reaper invasion. But this time the signal failed. The Keepers did not respond. Sovereign's allies were trapped in the void. Alone, it was forced to try and discover what had gone wrong.
Man, that's so terrible, because basically the Reapers would have already attacked. We would all be wiped out this very moment if the Protheans hadn't done what they'd done. If the signal hadn't failed, this wouldn't even be happening. Man, this is insane. They could just attack.
Sovereign's the largest ship in the galaxy. Why all this secret? Why not just attack the Citadel?
Sovereign is not invincible. Revealing its true nature would have united the forces of every organic species against it. Even a Reaper couldn't survive such odds. But the Reapers are patient. They will not rush into the unknown. Sovereign could have been planning this for centuries, moving deliberately, gathering allies. Slowly, it has assembled the pieces of the puzzle, working through agents to keep itself hidden. Saren is the most visible pawn of the Reapers, but I doubt he was the first. Now Sovereign has grown bold, whether from confidence or desperation I cannot say, but it is determined to reopen the portal to dark space.
Man, okay, so I'm kind of wondering if Sovereign has other pawns, so to say, working through, or, you know, people working through him. I wonder if I've met any of them. Like, I wonder if it's even, like, well, I guess they have to be indoctrinated to work for Sovereign, so anyone indoctrinated is Sovereign's, basically, hands, right? Alright, beacons.
What about the beacon on Eden Prime? And the one on Vermeier? What were they for?
At our apex, the beacons spanned the breadth of our empire. We used them as a single galaxy-wide network to transmit data and communications rapidly from world to world. Virtually all the beacons were destroyed during the invasion, but once the Reapers were gone, the survivors here on Ilos decided to risk sending out a message. We knew it was unlikely there were other survivors, but if there were, we wanted them to know about Ilos. We wanted to give them hope, so a message was sent across the network.
Wow, so that's what all of this has been coming up to. Quite the risk.
You could have exposed yourself to the Reapers.
In truth, we didn't expect any of the beacons would still function, but we had to try. If there were survivors, we had to reach them. The message was meant for our own people. It was coded so only organic beings could interpret it. We still didn't understand the power of Reaper indoctrination. We never realized it could lead an agent of the machines, like Saren, to this world. But it has also led you here. So perhaps we did not fail after all.
Oh man, so it's all been coming down to this. Everything was set up for this moment. Oh man, this is so cool. Okay, Keepers.
So when the Reapers created the Citadel, they created the Keepers as well?
A more likely scenario is that the Keepers were one of the early harvested civilizations. Perhaps the very first. Perhaps they responded well to indoctrination, or the Reapers simply bred them to be obedient. In any case, they were left behind to operate and maintain the Citadel. But the Keepers are no longer directly controlled by Sovereign or its ilk. They evolved so that they only respond to the signals emitted by the Citadel itself. When the Protheans altered the Citadel's signals, they broke Sovereign's hold over the Keepers. Now, they are completely harmless.
Wow. That explains the Geth.
Sovereign must have realized organic races were difficult to control.
A likely hypothesis. The Keepers evolved in an unanticipated direction. Non-organic servants like the Geth would be more predictable.
Oh my gosh. Okay, well, I guess I've talked to Vigil about everything, so let's move.
Saren's got enough of a head start. Grab that data file and let's go.
Shepard, are you sure? Who knows how much longer Vigil will be here? Even now, the projection is weak. This might be our only chance to speak with it, our only link to the knowledge of the Protheans. It is the opportunity of a lifetime.
Honestly, you're right, but world's ending over in the other direction. I agree with you, but do what you can in like 30 seconds, you're right.
It might know something useful.
I will provide whatever information I can. My data banks, however, are limited to information directly related to stopping the Reaper invasion.
Okay, alright, I guess this is the last time I'll ever get to talk to Vigil, so if it wants to drive any of these points home. Okay, time to go.
I've got the file, come on.
The one you call Saren has not reached the conduit. Not yet. There is still hope if you hurry.
Oh, man. So that, just like that, Vigil's gone now, huh? Wow. Well, that was a moment. I'm guessing the barrier will probably be down now if I go through the elevator, which, how long did all that take? Hold on. Oh my. Okay, well, I've already been playing for close to 27 minutes-ish, so, I should probably just leave it here for now, because, I'm sorry that the whole episode is just me having my mind blown by Vigil, but I guess it's how these games go sometimes. Thank you guys so much for watching me play Mass Effect, and wow, how about that with Vigil? Next time I guess I'll go down this elevator and do what I can to stop Saren from, you know, ruining everything. Wow, well, I'm gonna go just have my mind blown the rest of the day. Thank you guys so much for watching me play Mass Effect, and I guess we're getting near the end here. I guess we're gonna stop Saren and stop Sovereign in the next episode or two, hopefully. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching me play Mass Effect, and I'll see you with another episode soon. Thanks again, and bye for now.